Today's topic is renin angiotensin system. This is one of the autoregulatory mechanism which is activated whenever our body required. Like in case of falling blood pressure, body try to maintain it by activation of renin angiotensin system. Session we can cover about the synthesis, receptors and the functions of renin angiotensin system. Drugs inhibit the renin angiotensin system. Pharmacology of angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors, pharmacology of angiotensin receptor blockers, and the role of renin inhibitors. How angiotensin 2 is synthesized? For the synthesis of angiotensin 2, two substrates were required. One is angiotensinogen, which is secreted from the hepatic cell, and another one is renin, which is released from the juxtaglomerular cells of the kidney. With the help of renin, angiotensinogen is converted to angiotensin 1. As such, angiotensin 1 is in an inactive form. It is converted to its active form, and that is angiotensin 2 with the help of angiotensin converting enzyme. This synthesized angiotensin 2 binds with its own receptor and it produces various functions. One of the functions is it produces vasoconstriction. And that vasoconstriction is helpful to increase blood pressure. Another function which is generated is release of aldosterone. And that aldosterone, we know that the function of aldosterone is to retain sodium and water. Retention of sodium and water enhance the fluid volume, and that increased volume can further increase blood pressure. This angiotensin 2 further metabolize to its metabolic product like angiotensin 1 to 7 with the help of another type of angiotensin converting enzyme that is known as an ACE type 2. The role of angiotensin converting enzyme is to metabolize bradykinin. That bradykinin is synthesized from the kininogen. That bradykinin produces various functions like to increase release of nitric oxide, which is endothelium derived relaxing factor, it increase the synthesis of prostaglandin. So the function of nitric oxide and prostaglandin is to produce vasodilatation and sodium excretion. So here you can see that opposite functions were generated with the bradykinin if we can compare it with the angiotensin 2. While angiotensin 2 produces vasoconstriction and retain sodium and water, while bradykinin produce vasodilatation and increase sodium excretion. How angiotensin 2 produce the reaction? By binding with its own receptor. There are two type of receptor, angiotensin type 1 and angiotensin type 2 receptor. Majority of functions of angiotensin 2 are generated through binding with the angiotensin type 1 receptor. They are present at various sites like on a vascular smooth muscle and myocardium, while type 2 they are present at fetus tissue, and in adult they are present at the adrenal medulla. The functions which are produced through stimulation of type 1 receptor like vasoconstriction, enhance the cell proliferation, retain sodium and water, and enhance the secretion of aldosterone. While totally opposite functions were generated through stimulation of type 2 receptor, that is vasodilatation, apoptosis, and inhibition of cell proliferation. Now, the functions of renin angiotensin system, again, it is just a revision. Here, we can see that major three functions are produced with the angiotensin 2. One of them is they produce directly systemic vasoconstriction, as well as it also produce indirectly vasoconstriction through stimulation of sympathetic nervous system. So that is one function. Second function which is generated is increase in the blood volume. So that increase in the blood volume by multiple mechanism. One of them is through adrenal cortex, aldosterone release is increased that retains sodium and water, which helpful to enhance the blood volume. Another way, through pituitary gland, increase in antidiuretic hormone release. The role of this hormone is again to retain sodium and water. So that is helpful to increase blood volume and directly stimulating the thrust center, and that helpful to increase the blood volume. So the second function which is generated is increase in a blood volume. And the third function which is associated is cardiac and vascular hypertrophy. Angiotensin 2 having ability to synthesize various protein, and those protein were accumulated on a myocardial tissue as well as vascular tissue, and they can alter the structure of cardiac and vascular mucosa. See that cardiac tissue, when the renin angiotensin system, when they are in an active state, there is an excessive accumulation of those protein can alter the cardiac structure and leads to hypertrophy of heart. In the same way, in the vascular smooth muscle, intimal growth is enhanced in presence of angiotensin 2. So that intimal growth can narrow the vascular lumen, and the narrowing of vascular lumen may leads to increase in a pressure. Now, how we can inhibit the renin angiotensin system? That system can be inhibited by various ways. One way is by using beta blockers. As you know that beta receptors are mainly present at extraglomerular cells of the kidney, and that stimulation can enhance the renin release. If we are using beta blockers, renin is not available and the whole renin angiotensin system is suppressed. Or we can use directly renin inhibitor. So that direct renin inhibitor can prevent the formation of renin. Another way is by using angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors. This is a step through which angiotensin 1 in active form is converted to angiotensin 2 in an active form. Or we can directly use the angiotensin receptor blocker through which angiotensin produces its function. And lastly, we can use aldosterone antagonist like spironolactone. So the functions of aldosterone can be suppressed in presence of antagonist. So we can discuss in detail about the angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors and ARB. Angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors, there are number of AC inhibitors were available. First one which is synthesized is captopril in 1977, and then after number of AC inhibitors were synthesized like enalapril, lisinopril, benzpril, imidapril, perindopril, ramipril, fosinopril or terindopril. So almost all AC inhibitors serves the similar mechanism of action. Their indication are similar, but they can differ in a three different property. So the difference between AC inhibitors are according to their potency. That how potent the AC inhibitors are, how at which particular dose they are able to inhibit the angiotensin converting enzyme. So they differ according to their potency. They can differ either by inhibition of AC inhibitor by drug or its metabolite. Many of angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors can directly inhibit the enzyme, or some of them can act as a prodrug. After metabolism, they convert it to its active metabolite, and that active metabolite able to inhibit the enzyme. And they will differ according to their pharmacokinetic property like bioavailability, plasma half-life, duration of action, etc. Regarding mechanism of action of angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors, so those drugs can inhibit the ACE enzyme. Inhibition of that enzyme may prevent the formation of angiotensin 2. If angiotensin 2 is not available, it produces vasodilatation instead of vasoconstriction, that is a vasodilatation. decrease the indirect sympathetic activation. So there is a decreased sympathetic tone. There is a decreased sodium and water retention. And there is a reduced aldosterone. And if angiotensin 2 is not available, there is no synthesis of those proteins which can alter the cardiac structure. So that may lead to reduced cardiac and vascular remodeling. And bradykinin metabolism is also prevented. That means there is accumulation of bradykinin. And one of the functions which is associated with the bradykinin is to increase prostaglandin synthesis. So that prostaglandin is again helpful to produce vasodilatation. So directly or indirect way, it produces a vasodilatation. Now, pharmacological effect which produce with the ACE inhibitors, they produce vasodilatation, increase bradykinin, through which there is a vasodilatation is produced. The effect of ACE inhibitor were differ. Like the person is sodium repleted person, in those person, repeated dose of ACE inhibitors can reduce a blood pressure. Like if the person is in a normal sodium intact or they are not taking any drug which can reduce the sodium ion. So their sodium level is in a normal level, or the person is sodium repleted. So the single dose of ACE inhibitor cannot reduce the blood pressure, but repeated doses of ACE inhibitor can reduce the blood pressure. Like if person is sodium depleted person, that single dose of ACE inhibitor can reduce the blood pressure. Like in case of person who are having not taking sodium intact, or the person who are on a drug therapy like diuretic therapy, that therapy can eliminate more and more sodium ion. That means the person is sodium depleted person. In those person, if single dose of ACE inhibitor were administered, that single dose of ACE inhibitor can reduce the blood pressure. That means the caution should be taken if the person are taking diuretics or the person is sodium depleted. That single dose of ACE inhibitor may lead to development of hypotensive effect. Pharmacokinetic parameters. Almost all ACE inhibitors were cleared by the kidney. So it is necessary to maintain the doses in case of renal failure. So those adjustment is necessary in a renal failure. Comparative features of ACE inhibitors. Here if you can compare captopril, lisinopril, enalapril, fosinopril or ramipril. Out of all this, captopril and lisinopril both are directly inhibiting angiotensin converting enzyme, while others where we act as a prodrug. So they need conversion into an active metabolites, and that metabolite inhibit the enzyme. So enalapril is converted to enalaprilate, fosinopril is converted to fosinoprilate, and ramipril is converted to its active metabolite. Now regarding their bioavailability, highest bioavailability is there with the captopril, while others having least bioavailability and the less bioavailability with the lisinopril, that is 25%. Regarding the plasma half-life, if we can compare the plasma half-life of all ACE inhibitors, highest plasma half-life is there with the ramipril, while least is with the captopril, that is 2 hours. All ACE inhibitors were excreted through renal, cleared by the kidney. Exception is there that fosinopril, which is also eliminated through hepatic tissue. So in case of renal failure, if at all if it is mandatory to use ACE inhibitor, the drug of choice for ACE inhibitor is fosinopril. It is safely used in those person. Regarding the duration of action, almost all having 24 or more than 24 hour duration of action. Exception is captopril. And if we can compare the doses or if we can compare the potency of individual AC inhibitors, highest potent is ramipril. It produces their action with minimum dose, that is 1.25 milligram per day. And the maximum dose which is required with the captopril, the starting dose of captopril is 25 milligram per day, and you can increase it up to 150 milligram per day. Regarding the adverse drug effect produced with the AC inhibitor, certain adverse drug reactions which are produced with the AC inhibitor like cough, angioedema and rashes. This adverse effect are mainly developed because of accumulation of bradykinin. So bradykinin accumulation may lead to dry, irritating cough, angioedema and rashes. Another adverse effect, as it is a fetopathic, it may produce harmful effect to the fetus, and that is why it is contraindicated, do not use during pregnancy. Then it also produces hypotensive effect, and that hypotensive effect is more marked observed when the person is sodium depleted. Test alteration, hyperkalemia, as more sodium and water is eliminated out, potassium ion is retained. So that retention of potassium ion may produce a hyperkalemia. It produces proteinuria and it produces acute renal failure. Again, there is a question that how it produces acute renal failure. If you can see that glomerular filtration rate is maintained by these two arterioles, efferent arterioles and the efferent arterioles. Efferent arteriole, if they are vasoconstricted, it can decrease the GFR, and if efferent arteriole produce vasoconstriction, it can increase the GFR. If prostaglandin is there, prostaglandin produce vasodilatation of efferent arterioles. So that vasodilatation is helpful to increase GFR. Same way, angiotensin II produce vasoconstriction of efferent arterioles, and that vasoconstriction can increase the GFR. So both the substance, prostaglandin and angiotensin II, are there to maintain or to increase glomerular filtration rate. Now if drugs like non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs were administered, they can decrease the prostaglandin synthesis. So that decreased prostaglandin can produce vasoconstriction, and that vasoconstriction leads to reduction in a GFR. Same way, if AC inhibitors were administered, that AC inhibitors can produce vasodilatation, and that vasodilatation can reduce a GFR. So if AC inhibitors were administered, there is a chance to produce vasodilatation and reduction in a GFR. And if it is administered along with the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, there is a further reduction in a glomerular filtration rate. And if GFR is reduced, we can see that there is a development of acute renal failure. Various drug interactions are produced with the AC inhibitors. Most commonest is like with antacid. If AC inhibitors were administered with the antacid, most of the AC inhibitors, their bioavailability in between 25 to 60%, exception is captopril. So with antacid, there is a further reduction in a bioavailability. With non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, there is a reduction in the effect of AC inhibitors. With the lithium clearance is reduced in presence of AC inhibitors. So there is an accumulation of lithium, and there is a chance to produce lithium toxicity. with potassium sparing diuretic. As such, ACE inhibitors can also retain a potassium ion, and along with the potassium sparing diuretic, there is a further retention of potassium ion. So that leads to hyperkalemic effect. So this is all about this session. Other aspects regarding ACE inhibitor, their therapeutic application, angiotensin receptor blocker, and renin inhibitor, we can cover it in a next session. Thank you. Have a good day.